Hello students, this is Dr. Ranjini, Assistant Professor in Biotechnology. Today in this session, we learn about the importance of synthetic seeds, or otherwise called as artificial seeds, and their applications. Despite the successful sowing of in vitro produced somatic embryos directly into soil, now the research is going on in sowing these synthetic seeds or artificial seeds. Synthetic seeds are otherwise called as artificial seeds. Here what they do is, the mature somatic embryos are covered by chemical alginate, which contains some nutrients as replacement for endosperm. We know the difference between somatic embryo and the zygotic embryo. Zygotic embryo will be having the natural nutrient supplement, whereas in case of the somatic embryos, they lack this endosperm. So for that, to replace the endosperm, these artificial or the somatic embryos will be supplemented with the alginate that will give a sort of nutrient for the growing embryo. Along with this nutrient, which also has some fungicide, so that will be mixed with the alginate, so that will prevent the contamination or the infection. So these artificially prepared seeds or the somatic embryos are called as synthetic seeds. They can be sown just like conventional seeds into the soil. So what is the definition of synthetic seeds? Synthetic seeds are defined as artificially encapsulated somatic embryos. So it is not only the somatic embryos, along with that, we can also take the shoot buds and cell aggregates, or any other tissue can be encapsulated artificially and they can be used for sowing as seed. In simple words, synthetic seeds contain an embryo. Synthetic seed contain an embryo that is encapsulated, that is surrounded by the artificial medium that supplies the nutrients and is encased in an artificial seed covering. So this artificial seed preparation nowadays is gaining more importance, and it is having the advantages of clonal propagation, with those of the seed propagation and storage. And here, these are the pictures. They show the artificial seeds. So this is the sodium alginate that will be mixed with the calcium chloride to form the calcium alginate. So this calcium alginate will be having the jelly-like texture. So that will give the jelly-like appearance on the surface of the embryo, the somatic embryo that is encapsulated or it is placed inside the calcium alginate. So here in this colored picture, you can see here they have taken the shoot tips or the shoot buds. They have been encapsulated within the calcium alginate. So when it is grown on the media under in vitro condition, that will germinate and you'll find the development of the shootlets. Later, it will develop the roots also. So like this, we can grow these shoot buds or cell aggregates or any tissue encapsulated within this artificial seed. Next, we will move on to what are the uses of these artificial seeds. Reduced costs of transplant, direct greenhouse and field delivery, large-scale monoculture, large-scale we can produce this artificial seed, mixed genotype plantations. These are the carriers for adjuvants such as microorganism, plant growth regulators, pesticides and antibiotics. And it is possible to protect the unstable and elite genotypes. So these are the few uses of the artificial seeds. So they can be easily produced, they can be directly delivered to the greenhouse, they are produced in large numbers, and you can expect the mixed genotype plantation. Along with that, they can act as the carriers for adjuvants, and you can protect the unstable and elite genotypes by making or synthesizing the artificial seeds. Then, what are the applications of synthetic seed? After knowing the uses of the synthetic seed, what are the applications of synthetic seeds? By combining the benefits of vegetative propagation system with the capability of long-term storage and with the clonal multiplication, synthetic seeds have many diverse applications in the field. They can be stored for the longer duration, and they are produced along with the clonal multiplication, due to which it is having more application. Multiplication of non-seed producing plants, ornamentally important plants and polyploid plants can be multiplied using this, the artificial synthetic seed production. And it helpful in propagation of male or female sterile plants for hybrid seed production. Since we are concentrating more on the somatic tissue or the cell aggregate or the shoot bud or the somatic embryo, the propagation of the sterile plant is possible by the synthesis of the artificial seeds. This is one way of germplasm conservation, because you can conserve any somatic tissue by artificial seed preparation. This is another the method of multiplication of transgenic plants. So these are the few applications of a synthetic seed. But apart from this, the production of synthetic seed is very easy, and transportation is very easy. Along with that, we can store for the longer duration. These are the advantages of synthetic seeds. After having all these applications and uses, even the production of this artificial seed is having some limitations. Limitations include limited production of viable micropropagules that are useful in synthetic seed production. So maintaining the viability plays an important role. The storage of the synthetic seed plays an important role in maintaining the viable nature. Then another one is the asynchronous development of somatic embryos. Even in somatic embryogenesis, we saw the asynchronous development of the somatic embryos. When you isolate the somatic embryos, you cannot expect all the embryos to be there in the single stage. All the stages we will find. So that asynchronous development plays the main limitation in the development of the artificial seed. Then another one is improper maturation of the somatic embryos, that is due to asynchronous development, makes them inefficient for germination and conversion into normal plants. So improper maturation of the somatic embryo will limit the production and germination of the artificial seed. The lack of dormancy and stress tolerance in somatic embryos that limit the storage of the synthetic seed. You will come to know the different types of the synthetic seed, how we'll synthesize. And in all this, they lack the dormancy. And the stress tolerance in the somatic embryos is very less, due to which the storage, proper storage, play an important role in stress tolerance. Somaclonal variations, which may alter the genetic constituent of the somatic embryo. So somaclonal variation, when you regenerate the tissue culture plant, all the plant look alike, they will be same. That's why they are called as the clones, or the technique is called as clonal propagation. But here and there we find the variation, and these variations are called as somaclonal variation, because we find this variation in the tissue culture regenerated plant or clonally propagated plant, which are originated from the somatic tissue. So due to which, so this alter the genetic constituent of the embryo or the artificial seed. So these are the limitations in using the artificial seed. Next, we'll see how these synthetic seeds or artificial seeds are prepared. There are two methods of synthesizing the artificial seeds. One is the dropping method and another one is molding method. One is dropping method and another one is the molding method. The preparation of the synthetic seed could be done by using various water-soluble hydrogels like alginate, gelrite, carboxymethyl cellulose, and locust bean gum, and sodium alginate, etc. However, alginate-based encapsulation or synthetic seed preparation was found to be best. So this encapsulation could be done in two methods. One is dropping method and another one is the molding method. As the name suggests, first we'll learn about the dropping method. As the name suggests, here we are dropping the solutions of the sodium alginate into the solution of calcium nitrate or the calcium chloride. Here, what we do is, in this method, first somatic embryos will be grown and these somatic embryos will be mixed with 2% sodium alginate, solution. So all these steps will be done in a sterile condition under laminar airflow. 2% sodium alginate solution will be prepared in sterile water. And this will be mixed with the somatic embryos. So this sodium alginate will be prepared in the MS medium, Murashige Skoog medium. After mixing the embryos with the 2% sodium alginate in MS media, the percentage, I'm telling about 2%, it could be ranging up to 2 to 4%, depending on the texture and the hardness you want to standardize. So it may vary from 2 to 4%. So these encapsulated beads are then dropped as drops into the calcium nitrate. We have the sodium alginate that is mixed with the embryo, and these encapsulated or the embryo surrounding with the sodium alginate will be dropped into the sterile calcium nitrate or calcium chloride. The concentration will be around 0.1 molar or 100 millimolar. Here also, the preparation of the calcium chloride or the calcium nitrate is very important. This should be prepared in the sterile water. So after dropping the sodium alginate with the embryo into the beaker containing the 0.1 molar calcium nitrate, the solution with the encapsulated embryo will be kept undisturbed for at least 20 minutes. During this period, there is interaction between the sodium alginate and the calcium nitrate, and that results in the formation of the calcium alginate. As soon as the sodium alginate comes in contact with the calcium chloride, when it comes in contact with the calcium chloride, it results in the formation of the calcium alginate. So this calcium alginate will be in jelly-like texture. So your embryo will be there inside and it will be surrounded with the calcium alginate. So this formation of the calcium alginate with the embryo at the center should be undisturbed for 20 to 30 minutes. After 20 to 30 minutes, embryos are they will be completely gelled by the calcium alginate. So these gelled embryos are then rinsed with the sterile water and can be used as the synthetic seeds, or they are considered as the artificial seeds. This method has been used by the scientist Redenbaugh in 1986 for the alpha-alpha somatic embryo encapsulation. However, in the case of calcium nitrate, we can also use the calcium chloride for the encapsulation of the synthetic seed. So after forming the artificial seeds, you can directly sow it on the, or you can place it on the MS media under in vitro condition, or else you can store it for the longer duration by maintaining the particular or specific storage condition, either in liquid nitrogen or at minus 80 degree centigrade. So this is how we prepare the artificial seed, even in our practical classes, by using this dropping method. So this is very important as far as your theory as well as your practical classes. So you have to prepare these synthetic seeds under laminar airflow condition, under in vitro condition in the practical class. Next, we'll move on to the another method of preparation of the synthetic seed. This is the molding. In this method, embryos are mixed with the temperature-dependent gel. Temperature-dependent gel, like gelrite, where the cells get gelled as the temperature is lowered. So this gelrite will solidify when the temperature is reduced. So here this gelrite will be mixed with the embryos. So when the gelrite solidifies, along with that, even embryo will be encapsulated. But this method of synthetic seed preparation by using the molding method cannot be used directly into the fields, because they will be very fragile and their nutrients will be attacked by the microflora present in the soil, which will starve the embryo to death, or they will compete with the embryo for the nutrient. So hence, we use only the dropping method of synthetic seed preparation for the good germination, to avoid the infection by the other microorganisms. Next, we'll see what are the types of synthetic seed. Based on the technology established so far, there are two types of the synthetic seed. One is desiccated synthetic seed. The another one is hydrated synthetic seed. Desiccated synthetic seed and another one is hydrated synthetic seed. Desiccated synthetic seeds are produced from somatic embryos, either naked or encapsulated in polyethylene glycol. Polyethylene glycol, or it is otherwise called as polyoxar, 2% will be prepared, followed by their desiccation. So this desiccation can be achieved either slowly over a period of 1 or 2 weeks, sequentially using the chambers of decreasing relative humidity, or rapidly by unsealing the petri dishes and leaving them on the bench overnight to dry. So it can be done gradually or immediately by mixing your artificial seeds or the embryos with the 2% polyoxal, and this mixture will be placed on the Teflon plate for immediate synthetic seed preparation. And when the moisture is evaporated, it will form the synthetic seeds in the form of flakes. That is called desiccated synthetic seed. This type of desiccated synthetic seeds are produced only in plant species whose somatic embryos are desiccation tolerant. They are called desiccated synthetic seed. And another method of synthetic seed is hydrated synthetic seed, where the somatic embryos are not desiccation tolerant. Such type of somatic embryos will be encapsulated in the hydrated gel. They are called as the hydrated synthetic seed. And these are produced in those plants where, as I told earlier, they are recalcitrant and very sensitive for desiccation. And these hydrated synthetic seeds are produced by encapsulating the somatic embryos in the hydrated hydrogel or the calcium alginate. So till now, we learned the definition of the synthetic seed or the artificial seeds, how they are produced and their applications, uses. Along with that, we learned about the limitations of the synthetic seeds or the artificial seeds. Along with that, we saw the advantage of the artificial seeds over the zygotic embryos or the naturally produced embryos under the natural environmental condition. So this session will tell you the synthetic seeds and their applications. I hope you understood the session. Thank you.